Buongiorno, guten Tag, salam alaikum. Today we have the honor and the pleasure to have a special guest. Rebiya Kadeer is an exceptional figure in the minority rights movement who has devoted her own life for the freedom and fundamental rights of the Uyghurs. The Uyghurs are an ethnically Turkish population, most of whom are Muslims, and who live in the autonomous region of Xinjiang, that in Chinese means new frontier, a new dominion. The region is also called East Turkestan. And the region is situated in the northeastern part of China. Considering the economic power of China, the Uyghurs movement can be maybe described as a sort of Goliath and David situation. If we just think of the debt that the US has with China or the latest Google case. The region of Xinjiang has borders with many countries, the former Soviet Union states as Kazakhstan, Tajikistan, Kyrgyzstan, Afghanistan, but also with India and Pakistan. So the region is clearly placed in a political and military strategical position, but it's also placed in an economically strategical position for the oil and gas pipelines from Central Asia and for the natural resources of which the region is rich. The region has a population of approximately 17-20 million inhabitants, depending on the sources. And the Uyghurs are the largest ethnic group in the region, together with other approximately 12 ethnic groups. This territory has been independent in the past with the name of the Autonomous Republic of East Turkestan until the Chinese Han took control of this region after the Communist Revolution in 1949. Since then, the Chinese ethnically Han began arriving in large numbers through mechanisms typical of colonial control, a sort of demographic engineering through incentives and other policies of the government that support the spread of Han language, culture, and economic power. The Han now make up at least 40% of the population in the region compared with a 6% in 1949. In her biography, that has been described as a sort of epic-like, heroic legend, the book has been published in different languages, including Italian and German, and is the result of a number of interviews conducted by the German journalist Alexandra Cavelius, and in English has been recently published with a foreword of the Dalai Lama. And in his book, Rebiya Kadeer described not only her own story, but also the story of an entire population, the Uyghurs, and their suffering. And somehow, in this way, she follows what her parents has always told her, that you don't belong to us, the parents, but to the people, to our own people. Rebiya Kadeer, who is also mother of 11 children, has been a very successful businesswoman. She built an empire of trading companies and department store, and she was also appointed to the China's national legislative body. At a certain point, she was one of the richest person in China. China counting, you have to imagine, approximately 1 million and more inhabitants, and she was the richest woman in China. So business and money, as she said in her book, were her first contribution to the Uyghur movement, as money are, as she says, an essential element in the struggle for freedom. Rebiya Kadeer was not only a very successful businesswoman, but she was also an active philanthropist within the community, most notably through her foundation, A Thousand Families Mothers Project, a charity intended to help Uyghur women to start up their own local business. So business and money were considered to be a sort of means for the emancipation and empowerment of the individuals within the community, in particular of women. Since the 80s, she was very active, politically very active, in defense of the Uyghurs, and her most important political engagement was a speech she gave before the Congress in Beijing, in which she, with a lot of courage, switched to the approved text and denounced openly the situation in the region. After this speech and the exile of her husband, an intellectual and political dissident, who in 1996 left China for the USA, Mrs. Kadir's passport was seized and she was harassed by police. And in 1998, she was prevented from reappointment at the National Congress in Beijing. In August 1999, she was arrested on her way to meet a delegation from the US Congress with whom she wanted to complain about the situation of the political prisoners in the Uyghurs region. The Chinese government charged her with providing secret information to foreigners, even though these documents were publicly available. She was sentenced to 8 years imprisonment, then reduced by 1 year. And after more than five years in jail, in a region where prison conditions are extremely harsh, under pressure from the United States and other international organizations, she was freed in 2005, officially on medical grounds. She was then quickly deported and sent into exile in the USA. In the USA, after a few months after her arrival, she survived to an attempt on her life, and her family back in China has been since then subjected to various forms of harassment, including detention. While in exile, she became the president of the World Uyghur Congress, an umbrella organization for 47 groups worldwide, based in Munich, and also of the Uyghur American Association, which represents approximately 1,000 or so Uyghurs in the United States. She has been also nominated 3 times for the Nobel Prize, for the Nobel Peace Prize. In 2000, when she was in jail, she received also the prestigious Human Rights Watch Award, and later also the Norwegian Raftop Prize for Human Rights. In spite of the suffering and violations taking place in the Uyghurs region, still this minority is not very known, as for instance, the Tibetans. In Italy, as in many other European countries, the Uyghurs got the headlines of the media for 2 recent circumstances, the clashes and disorders that occurred in the Uyghur region just before the Olympic Games in March 2008, causing more than some embarrassment before the international public opinion for the Chinese authorities in their attempts to present an image of a peaceful and democratic country. And secondly, the request by the US authority to transfer to some European countries, including Italy, some prisoners, some Uyghurs prisoners from Guantanamo prisons. In the end, only Albania accepted, and others were transferred to Palau. The others refused directly or indirectly under the pressure of the Chinese authorities. These 2 stories illustrate very well the types of stories that our media select on minorities, stories that are often connected to violence, in particular if committed, somehow linked to the minority itself. Today, so we have the occasion to have a testimony from a leading figure of the Uyghur movement, who is herself the living example of how difficult and steep is the road for the affirmation and realization of human and minority rights. I apologize for having been so long, and now I give the floor to Mrs. Rebiya Kadeer.
Thank you. Thank you. Mersu zendike, Aldı bilen barlık, bugünkü muşu sorunga uyuştuğun barlık teşkilatlarga ve muşu müşerike hükümetten ismindesiniz buludu. Hükümet geçin kolumda rahmet eğitmen ve şunun ulan birge bugün muşu sorunga benim halkımga ve bizdek bir izilgen milletlerge kongul bölüp muş sorunu kegen barlık okuguçla ve hanım efendimlerge çünkü onun da rahmet ettim.
First of all, I would like to thank the provincial government of, you know, South Tyrol and Mrs. Marta Stucker and also European Academy to invite me for this wonderful event. And all, I would also like to thank all of the audience that come here to listen to the story of my people.
Мен барлык менин ахвалымны силерге туныштырып өттү. Мен эми өзүмдүн халкымдын ахвалын айтып өтөп кетей. Биздин силер биздин ахвалыбызды мен силерге мындай кылып туныштырыш үчүн мушу Тибеттин ахвалы менен окшош деп карасаңлар болду. Биз Бесивилинге вактыбыз Тибеттин 1 жыл мурун Бесивилиндик. Унун алдыда өзүбүз айрым бир жашаган айрым бир дөөлөт жана миллеттик. 49
So Roberta already explained briefly about the situation of my country and my people. And I would like to say that if you know about the Tibet, then you will learn more about the situation and fate of my people. Because the situation of our people is very similar to the Tibetan situation. The Chinese communists occupied East Turkestan, my land, 1 year before they occupied Tibet.
Lekin biz hazırgıça bu şundaq bir qattıq bir diktator dövlətinin astıda yaşap bir yoquluş qırdavığı iştirilib atqan bolsaq mı avazımızni dünyaya anıltamadıq.
Although my people suffered a lot under the Chinese rule, but we haven't had the chance to introduce our situation and suffering of our people to the international community.
Xitay hukumeti bizge 55-nji ýyly silerni yerlik milletler bolganlygyňyz üçin biz besibagandan kyn Şinjan Uyghur Awtonom Rayon degen hukukny birimiz öz taqdyrynlaryňy özeňler belgileýsizler, özeňler taraqqy kylysylar dep bizge awtonom hukuk bergen.
So after Chinese communists occupied East Turkestan, because we were the indigenous people of that land, they promised us that they will give a full autonomy to the region and guaranteed the autonomy to us and called our land as Xinjiang Uyghur Autonomous Region. And they promised us that they will respect all our rights and we will determine our future and our destiny.
Askerlerin ve onun aile tababatları bilen bulup aran 2% Xitaylarını götkep ekegen.
So when they occupied the East Turkestan, Chinese population, they were the families of the Chinese military who the Chinese authorities brought in to our land, and it constitutes only a few percent of the total population.
60 yıldan beri bunu bugün geçe, biz abdunumu hukuk digenden söz etiş mümkün emez. Bir gün mü demokratiya, erkinlik, kişilik hukuk digenden söz etiş mümkün emez. Bir gün mü tinişlikke erişemedik.
So since 60 years of Chinese occupation, the Uyghur people were suffering and they didn't of course keep their promises. And they violated all basic human rights of the Uyghur people and all the democratic rights of the Uyghur people, and my people didn't have a day of peace.
Uyghur halkı korkuş ve kaçan turmuğa ekte, kaçan öltüre, biz kaçan hayat kalamız diyen kündülerle ömrümüz ötti.
And we have been suffering for 60 years, and all of my people have been living under a threat, under fear of being arrested or being detained or being executed by the Chinese authorities.
Berilgen abdunumu hukukni qatti icra kılmadı.
So the Chinese authorities didn't carry out any of their promises, the promise of autonomy for my land.
Sen bergen abdunumu hukukni icra kıl dep tinişlik bilen talep kılgan rehberle, ziyalıyla ve namayişçilerin hemisi turmağı ilinip aldı ölüm cezası, keyni müddetsiz, müddetlik kamak cezası hüküm kılındı.
The Uyghur intellectuals and political activists who demanded the Chinese authorities to respect their promises and they kept their promises and respect the rights of the Uyghur people, the rights of the human rights of the Uyghur people, or have been detained, have been executed, and suffered a lot under the in prisons.
Bularning hammasi ash bergan abtunum huquqni talab qilganlar edi.
They have been not asking anything more. They have been asking just the Chinese government promised my people.
Bizning oldi bilan iqtisodiy jihatdan taraqqi qilish huquqimizni cheklayapti.
So they take all the measures so we cannot further our economic developments.
Namratlashtugandan keyin ma'arif jihatdan cheklandik.
And they also take some measures that they, you know, prevented our progress in our education.
Ondikin dini itiqadimizni chekladi.
And they limited our religious of freedom.
Ondikin köpüyüş hukukumuzni chekladi.
And also we didn't have even, you know, they launched a birth control policy and limited our, you know, being having the children.
Ondikin medeniyetimizni taraqqildirishni chekladi.
And also be, try to destroy our national culture.
2003 yildan boshlab ona tilimizni butunlay ma'rifdan qo'llab chiqib, til va yeziqimiz cheklandi.
So in 2003 they launched a new policy in banned the Uyghur language, banned the Uyghur language as language of instructions at schools and universities.
Millionlagan Xitoylarni yotkab chiqdi.
And the Chinese authorities brought in millions of Chinese immigrants from mainland China and resettled them in East Turkestan and changed the demography of our country.
U millionlagan Xitoylar yotkirib chiqsimi biz bilan ittifoq birlikda baxtli yashash emas bizni yo'qotish badaliga.
So they brought all these Chinese immigrants to our land not to live with us in peace. But the main goal of Chinese authorities was assimilate the Uyghurs and put them in minority in their own land.
Butunlay bizni Xitoy bo'lishga majburladi.
So they try to make us Chinese to and destroy our culture.
O'quv kichik 14 yoshdan 16 yoshgacha ballarimizni Xitoy o'lkalariga Xitoy tilida o'qishga majbur yotib ketildi.
And thousands of Uyghur children from 7 to 14, transferred thousands of Uyghur children from East Turkestan to mainland China to assimilate them in Chinese culture.
2006 yildan boshlab 14 yoshdan 25 yoshgacha to'y qilingan 400 ming qizimizni yotkab aketdi.
And in 2006, they launched a new policy of transferring young Uyghur girl and woman from East Turkestan to mainland China.
Bununga namayish qilib, tinchlik bilan faoliyat olib borgan. Mayli 97-yinchi yili, mayli 8-yinchi ayning 5-chi kuni ko'rdinglar, o'zining erkinligi, kishilik huquqi va avtonom huquq uchun namayish qilgan Uyg'urlarning namayishini to'planga o'zgartirib, ularni qonliq bastirdi.
And the people who raised, you know, their complaints and protested, you know, and then complained about Chinese policies and speak out about the Chinese policy to transfer young Uyghur women and girls from East Turkestan to mainland China. They were arrested by Chinese authorities, and Chinese authorities suppressed brutally the peaceful demonstrations in 1997 and also the 5th July of 2009.
Men Uyghurlarni bu o'zi yerlik millat bo'lgan bilan mayli ish o'rni yoki huquq yoki o'z tarixini o'zining tarixini o'rganish huquqi yoki televizorlarda chat allardagi bir demokratiya radiolarini anglash huquqi bo'lmaydi. Ushuni anglaganlarning hammasi turmaga tashlanadi.
So the situation is terrible. The Uyghur people don't have the right to speak out, to express their opinions, even to listen to the foreign broadcasts, to foreign radio stations.
Uyghurlar turmaga ilingandan keyin mushu o'zining erkinlik uchun tinchlik bilan faoliyat qilingan 10 minglagan Uyghurlar turmaga ilinadi. Ilinganlarning advokat taklif qilish huquqi bo'lmaydi, o'zini oqlash huquqi bo'lmaydi, xohlagancha o'lim jazosi va muddatsiz muddat qamoq jazosi hukm qilinadi.
There is no due process. The Uyghurs who have been detained by the Chinese authorities don't have the right to have a attorney, a lawyer to defend him at the courts, and the courts, the decisions are being made by political, you know, leaders, not by the judges, and the Uyghurs are being sentenced to long term of prisons and even being executed and sentenced to death.
Men bu kitabımı hakikaten Germaniyada gezildi. Ben sizlere bu kitabımı ne için yazganlığımı eğitip vermem.
So my the book was published, my this is the German version of my book was published first in Germany, and I would like to tell you why I decided to write this book.
Minglagan, on minglagan, millionlagan Uyghur kızları, Uyghur balları huddiymiş kitaptaki men.
So there are millions of, you know, Uyghur women and girls who have the same destiny as mine.
Men sizlerdek şunda partıda oturup o kuşni şunda arzu kılıp keçkeçilip yığılğan. Faqat Uyghur bop qalğanlığım üçün endi men sizler oqoğan mektepler kirip oqış pirisdigi erişenmedim.
When was I a child and was a young girl, I also wanted to be like you and study like you and sit at the end of these university chairs and have studied at the universities.
Uyghurlar faqat tarqaqlandırış, sürgün qilish, turmugu tutuş, muşundaq davrını başdan keçirdi.
So they, but I didn't have that chance. The Chinese authorities didn't give and don't want to give the Uyghur, young Uyghur women and girls that chance you have here. So they always, they constantly live in fear, in deportation, in suffering.
Men muşu yettay içindeki işini de preislege.
I would like to tell you what happened in the last 7 months in my land.
30 milyondan artık adam yaşaydıgan Şarkı Türkistan'da bütünlüğü internetle takaklık.
So in East Turkestan, which has a population of nearly to 30 millions, the Chinese authorities blocked all the internet access and telephone. They cut telephones.
1500'den artık website takılıp bütün website aşkallarının başlıkları turmak elindi.
They shut down more than 1,500 websites, the Uyghur websites, and they arrested all the people, all the editors of those websites.
Her kandak Uyghur'unu bastırış için terörist, milli bölgünçü diken kalpakını kaydırdı.
They found a new excuse, a label as terrorists, extremists, and fundamentalists to suppress and crack down on Uyghurs.
Bu bizni bastırış için bizge 60 yıldan beri atap kevatkan getle.
So they have been using these expressions since, you know, 60 years to suppress the Uyghur descent.
And the Uyghurlarning ahvali, Uyghurlar yani unundan başka özünün dünyanın hem yerine halıganç pasport edip çıkıp gitmeydi.
And the Uyghurs even don't have the right to get a passport to leave the country and travel abroad.
Öz vatanında asli hatırcam yaşamaydı.
So they cannot live comfortably in their own land.
Şunun için ben özümün ki halkımın avazını dünyaya anlatış için ben turmak kirdim, uyardan çıktım. Ben bu kitap bilen özümlam emez. Muş bir milletinin, muşu yer şehrindeki bir milletinin üntünsüz, avazsız, kandak yokulu vatkanlığını, kandak izli vatkanlığını dünya halkı uksun de. Ben muş Germaniyelik Aleksandra Hanım'a özümün ve halkımın ehvalini özüm bilen bir sözle verdim.
So, I have been arrested in China and spent more than 5 years in prison because I spoke out against the Chinese policies toward my people. And when I released from the prison, I decided to write this book to introduce the situation of my people to the international community.
Meslek onunlap desem köp bişinlar kubul kılanmaslığınla mümkün. 2008 yılı 1. ayının 18. sot başlığının dünyaya özünün ilan kığında Şarkı Türkistan'da milli bölgünçilerden biz 15 milyonu kolga aldık dep ilan kıldı.
The situation in my land is so terrible and even you will not believe what's happening there if I tell you. Even in 2008, January 2008, the Supreme Court chief of the East Turkestan himself announced that they have arrested in the last 5 years 15,000 people, political prisoners, Uyghur political prisoners.
Muşu 7. ayının 5. günü tınıştık bilen çıkan namayışını Xitay hükümeti topulanı özgertip 10 mıngdan artık Uyghur şu bir akşamın işini bastırılıp kayıp olup gitti.
On 5th July 2009, there was a peaceful demonstration in Urumqi and the Chinese authorities turned this peaceful demonstration into a bloody event and arrested thousands of people and only in one night more than 10,000 people have been disappeared.
Bütün yokalganlar toluksuz otur mektep, toluk attır mektepinin okuguçları köpünce kolu elinip yokalganlar en aşı itip öldürüldü ve bastırılıp öldürüldü.
So most of the people who have been disappeared were the teenagers and students like you, the students of the universities.
Tınıştık bilen çıkan bir namayışını bastırış için Xitay hükümeti maksatlı toplanığı özgertti.
So it was a peaceful demonstration and Chinese authorities in order to crack down that demonstration, suppress this demonstration, turned it in a year, provoked it and turned it into a bloody event.
Mana endi hazır ta bugünkü iki ay içinde özünün dünyaya ilan kalanlığı, ölüm cezası hüküm kıldık dedi, beş kitim ölüm cezası da iki ay içinde 28 adamını dünyaya ilan kıldı. Bu aşkarı ilan kal, mınlıgan adamlar turmada urup öldürdü batıdı. Yoka her günü Uygurların içinden, her günü Şarkı Türkistan'da, yani Şincan Uygur Abdunum rayında her günü yüzlep, 200'lep yaşlığa kayıp olup getirdi.
So the Chinese authorities in the last 2 months sentenced 28 people to death, and they carried out more than 9, death sentences. And since then, you know, hundreds of people have disappearing every day. The arrest and detention have been continued since then.
Mana bizlarni Abdunum rayon kentlar bizmo. Bizning xalqimiz tinchlik Abdunum rayon degan bilan bo'g'a ahvolni so'zlab berdim. Savolinglar bo'lsa bersanglar.
So you're also an autonomous region. You're enjoying the autonomy that was granted to you, and I'm very happy to be here today. And if you have any questions, I'm ready to answer.
Anlığınızla rahmet.
Thank you very much for listening.
Much, Mr. Kadeer. I read in your book that you have a nickname when you were in the business. Your nickname was Janagir, which is a woman who seduces everywhere she goes. And we can understand now how truth is this nickname, because they were all, I think, very fascinated by her. Before opening a discussion with the public, I will profit from my role by raising a first question. But please prepare your question, because the microphone will then collect your question. My first question is about the identity of the Uyghurs. We know that most of the Uyghurs are of Muslims of Islamic faith, and that this has been also used by the Chinese authorities to somehow label the Uyghurs movement as separatist, independentist, but also fundamentalist. And you also say in your book that September 11 was a big problem for the entire world, but it was a defeat also for the Uyghurs movement. Again, on Islam and Muslim faith, in your book you describe also the very strange, very odd relationship between the communism and Islam, how the communists succeeded in using Islam in order to force people to obey to the communist rules. And you describe also the story of this Imam Arunham. Arunham. And so I would like to know a bit more about this, the Uyghurs' identity in terms of religion, and how this has also somehow was also a problem for the movement itself.
Мәйлі ислам динді болсын, мәйлі христиан динді болсын, рахмет сіздің әштәқығыңыз. Әр қандақ динді қосақты ке түрік балыны өлтіріш бүтін динлада бұл қаршы елінмайды.
So thank you very much for your questions. So of course, every religion, whether it is Islam and Christianity, it's prohibit the abortion.
Lekin Xitoy hukumatı bazen bizninki yalğan musulmanlarni nahit çoğ ahun musulman qilib chiqib ap chiqib ularni mushu dinda ballaringlarni qo'shqinglardagi ballaringlarni tug'manglar o'ltirib elibassanglar bo'ladi deb so'zlaydi. Sözlüdü.
So Chinese authorities, of course, they train certain people as imams at the mosques, and they are at the mosque. They are preaching, you know, that it is not the sense. It is the, it doesn't matter if you know the abortion is allowed in the religion, so you can have an abortion. So they actually, you know, approve the government policies.
Unda qilib beshig'i sallini yo'g'ab, unda yolg'on so'zlaydigan musulmonlarni ochiq qalqni aldaydi. Yana biri Uyg'urlar musulmon bo'lganligi uchun terrorist deb bastirdi.
So of course also Chinese authorities are using these imams to, you know, to let the people to obey the policy, to approve the policy of the Chinese government. In one hand, in the other hand, they of course using the Islam to blame, to accuse the Uyghur movement, the Uyghur dissidents as, you know, fundamentalists and as terrorists.
And the Uyghur Muslims and dini jihatdan okugan alim bo'lib ketilgan ilmi musulmonlarning hammasi turmaga tashlanadi.
So of course there are a lot of real imams who studied the Islam in different countries, and they are real know the Islam very well. Of course all of them have been arrested by the Chinese, and they are spending long prison terms in prisons in East Turkestan.
Ulanın ismin terörist deb ataydı. Hiç mi değişim yok.
So they are terrorists, you know. They blame them as terrorists, accuse them as terrorists and put them in jail.
And the onundan sırt Ramazan ve namaz okuganlarni yaşlarının 18 yaşının tüvelleri meçitke kirgenler mektepten kovlap çıkırıldı.
So they say that they allow the mosques are open, the government is respect rights of the religious rights, and there are no limitation for the religious activities, but in the reality the education, the religious education for the children under 18 is prohibited, and the government employees, students and teachers are not allowed to enter mosques, and they are not allowed to fast during the Ramadan.
Ramazanda her qanda xizmet orullarida haraq ve yemekliklerini koyup koydu, onu yemek kirketkende xizmetten kovulundu.
So even the Chinese authorities organizing special events during the Ramadan, and they let the people eat during the day. So they are bringing even alcohol and every kind of, you know, things to let the people eat. If somebody refuses to eat, then he will be fired from his position.
Bizning xalqimiz mush odatdagi bir rasmiy xudoga bir to'niydigan mushnaq yavosh bir musulmon xalq, lekin Xitoy hukumatı bu musulmon degan bu ismni bizni bastirish uchun yana bir ise bizni aldash uchun ikki xil usulda ishlatadi.
So of course we are Muslims, the Uyghurs have a Muslim identity, but we are a moderate Muslims, and but Chinese authorities have been using Islam and both for, you know, let approve his policies for, by the imams, and the other, in the other hand, to suppress us, to crack down on the Uyghurs as separatists and as terrorists.
Bu kitabımda bir imamın kulakını Uygurlar kesip tutdu.
So I of course I tell a story in my book about the an imam at which the his ear was cut by some people in East Turkestan.
Sebep planlıq tuğutta xotullarının qosquduki ballarını öltəsi buludu deyə məscidlərdə sözləydi o imam.
Because he issued a fatwa, you know, religious instruction to the people that it is allowed in religion, the abortion is allowed in Islam.
Nurgunluğan balılar, nurgunluğa anılar aparasiyadı ölüp ketkenlik üçün xalq qəzəblənib ketib aşıq imamğa aşnaq muamilə qılan.
So the people were very upset and they punished him by cutting his ear.
I would like to ask the public now to...
Mrs. Kadeer, you have been nominated for the Nobel Peace Prize for 3 times, and from my view, you did deserve it. Now, in 2009, not you, but Barack Obama got that prize, and he's the most powerful man, maybe along with Hu Jintao, the most powerful man on the world. What do you expect him to do for peace and justice and the rights of the Uyghur people? And as far as you know, has he been addressing the issue of the Uyghur people, the political issue of Uyghur people in China, when he was visiting Beijing in the in recent month?
Qoymadı. Uyghurlar bugünkü öldürülüb atdı.
As I told you, the Chinese authorities continues to crack down on Uyghurs.
Kişilik hüquq düşündək məyli Tibet olsun, məyli Uyghur olsun, qatdıq dəbsəndi bovatdı.
Of course, the human rights of Uyghurs as well as Tibetans are being violated severely.
Milli qırğınçılıqqa cultural genocide duş gəldi.
So there is a cultural genocide are going on in East Turkestan and in Tibet.
Biz şundaq yığıldıq, şundaq toğulduq, bütün dünya bizni qutuldurub askəndi.
So we have been trying very hard to convince the international community and the world leaders to condemn the brutality and the cultural destruction in our regions.
Lekin dünyanın Xitay hökumətinin iqtisadi cəhətdəki müəmmələsinə qarab bizimki kişilik hüquq məsələmiz oturub qoyulmadı.
But our calls have been ignored because of the because of the economic power of the Chinese government.
Ədəbimizni öldürüşləm emas, hətta neçə min il tarixki igi olğan asaratiqi qaşqanımı çıxıb taşlığanda şunundumu biz avazımızı anıltamadıq dünyaya.
The Chinese authorities are not only executing and arresting the Uyghurs, but also they are destroying our culture. We tried very hard and asked the world to prevent the Chinese authorities from, you know, demolishing the old city of Kashgar. The Chinese authorities destroyed a history in Kashgar, but there was the world was silent.
Nobel mükafatını bana biri vitede deyip ensirep Norveç'e ve Nobel mükafatı komitetlerine Xitay hükümeti kat besim işletti ve tehdit saldı. Her yıl eğer Rabiya Kadir Nobel mükafatı bir dağın olsa Norveç'e bile ve şu devletle bile boğa münasvetinin üzümüzde taşkışlan ministeri vakırdı.
Of course, I have been nominated 3 times for Nobel Peace Prize, but every time when I was nominated, the Chinese authorities were involved, and Chinese authorities were putting pressure on Norwegian government and also, you know, Nobel Committee and also the governments in the region to not award me with Nobel Peace Prize. Other there will be severe, you know, repercussion from the Chinese side.
Nobel mukafatı tinçlik, şereflik bir mukafat erkinlik için verilgen. Meningçe Obama hükümeti, Obama efendim bunu ağandekin çukun bunun ödüstün çıkış kerek ve şununğa layık vazifeni orundaş kerek.
So of course the Nobel Peace Prize is very very honored peace prize, and in 2009 President Obama, you know, again the Nobel Peace Prize was given to President Obama, and I think he by getting the Nobel Peace Prize, he also, you know, now bear a more big responsibility in assuring the world that the human rights should be respected in every corner of the world. But of course, a bloody incident happened in July 5th, and Chinese authorities arrested thousands of people, hundreds of people have been killed in detentions, but there was no a war. President Obama didn't raise his voice even in that period of time.
I would like to raise another question before maybe the public will think of another question. It's about the so-called kin state. In your book, you mentioned just once Turkey, and not very positively, I have to say, because you say that probably there was a sort of a hidden agreement between Turkey and China in order not to look at each other's minorities, so Kurds and Uyghurs and Tibetans. So, and we know also here in South Africa how important is for minority protection the role of a kin state here, for example, is the role of Austria. So, and you said also in your book that when you went to a UN Congress of the United Nations for Women's Rights, you heard the first time the representatives of the Tibetans, as you've seen how sort of powerful were, and how the Uyghurs instead were sort of alone. So how do you leave this sort of situation of being without a kin state, with so many countries refusing somehow the help because of the Chinese power, and probably you have very few countries on which you can count on? USA or maybe Canada, Norway. How is the relationship with the authorities, for example, also in Italy, when you come to visit these countries? So a sort of network of friends that can support your movement.
İtalya hükümeti mesela demokrasi değil, Amerika kullanıyor vatandaşı.
Biz burunqığı nisbətən muşu 5 bulub mu muş 5-6 yıldan beri Amerika hökuməti və Qərb dünyası və İtaliya hökuməti bizim işimizi qollayırdı.
So of course since 5 or 6 years the Western countries, the US and also European countries and including Italy has been supportive for the Uyghur cause.
Burun biz özümüz anlatamadık çünkü Xitay bizim katkı kontrol edip sırtkı çıkamayalı için.
So before that there was no support for us in the West because the reason was that there were no Uyghurs to introduce itself, introduce the issue to the Western public because Chinese were controlling strictly the Uyghurs and they didn't allow the Uyghurs to come out of the countries and go to the Western countries and resettle there.
Ben hazırlık için tek Türkiye'ye kırmadım.
So I have not been able to visit Turkey yet.
Burun bana Türkiye vizi vermiyor.
So a few years ago, Turkey, of course, rejected my application for a visa application.
Lakin bu kitim 7 ayının 5'indeki vakadın ki Türkiye hükümeti dünyaya ait katlık, Xitay'a katlık pozisyon bildirdi.
But during the 5th July incident, when that incident happened, the Turkish authorities, the Turkish government took a very strong stand against the Chinese government. So I hope that this position of Turkey will continue and it will continue to support the Uyghurs.
İtalya Radikal Partisi.
The Italian authorities.
Ve başka orullar ve neşriyatlar. Ziyalılar ve parlamentleri çok yakışık bizim kollavatıdı. And Amerika mı, şu Amerika bulup mu Amerika Kongresi, Avrupa Parlamenti biz doğrulu kanunlaya çıkardı. Asta asta bizim meselemizi düşünüp hazır yardım kılışkı başladı.
So also Italian authorities and also some, you know, NGOs in Italy are supporting us. We are very grateful for that. And also the US government also have been supporting us and the European Union as well, and European Union recently adopted a resolution condemning the Chinese policy in East Turkestan.
President Bush ba vaqtida bizni Aqsaray'a ekirib, ahvalimizni Aqsaray'da qabul qilib oldi.
And during the Bush administration, as I was, you know, invited twice to White House and met with President Bush.
I would very like to know how do you get news from your country meanwhile you are here in Europe traveling. Thank you.
How do you get information from your country?
Әмі нәрсі етек, әмі ұшы сұртқы чыққаладың, сұрттың кіргеладың арқылық қабар алалып атымыз.
So as I have told you, all the communication lines are cut, but we are getting information from the people who are you know, coming from our land abroad, visiting abroad, traveling abroad.
Менің ішкі балам тұрмыда, үш балам назарат астыда, етті нәуірен мәктептен қоғланған, әтті өйлерін тат өліп балларымын қоғлап чықырыпты. Şulanın mı hazır nədligin oxumayma xəbərini özəmnin ailəsinə kirim alamadım.
So of course 12 my children are in prison and 3 of them are under Chinese surveillance and my extended family have been kicked out from their houses and my 9 of my grandchildren were kicked out from the schools and I have been trying to contact them and since many months I were not able even I've not been able even to communicate with them, to speak with them.
6 qavat bir, 7 qavat bir binarım var. Bunun da 2000-dən artıq Uyğur sodigarlar yaşayırdı.
I have a department store in Urumqi and there were about 2000, you know, Uyghurs doing business in that department store.
Binanı hazır bikala bütün sodigarları qoğlab çıxırıb, onların təqdirinin qandaş boğallığını oxumayma.
And Chinese authorities, in order to take revenge from my activities, evacuated my department store and kicked out all of the people who have been doing business there. So even I don't know what happened to them. So I don't have any communication with them.
Hello. I've got two questions. First, apart from Turkey, what kind of support and how much help do you get from other Muslim countries in the world? And the second question, what do you hope to achieve for your cause and for your people by visiting our region here?
Biz dünyaya hem de anlatıvatımız, yani İslam dünyası hem de anlatıvatımız belki hem de bunun için yardım kılış mümkün.
So as I told you, we have been, you know, very new our cause to the world. So now I hope that the more Islamic country, as they find out what's happening in our land, will support our cause.
Lakin Garip dünyası bizli yakşı yardım kılıp.
And as in Western countries were very supportive, and we are very grateful of them.
Yeterlik derecede bulmuşumuz, işkilip herhalde yakşı.
So the support, I'm telling you that this they are supportive, but it's not enough, of course. We want them to do more.
İşkincisi bir egzi yaratık. Şimdi bu bir Abdunum Rayınken, biz mi bir Abdunum Rayın boğulu 60 yıl oldu?
So this South Tyrol is an autonomous region, is a very successful autonomous region, and we have been also an autonomous region, our region, for 60 years. So I wanted to just to compare the situation here with the situation in my homeland.
İkinci, benim halkımın ahvalını anlatış ve bulanın mı halkının yardımına eriştiriş.
Secondly, I wanted to explain the situation of my people to the people here, to you, and get your support as well.
Hem alaylılığın ügünüş.
And also I wanted to know, to get more detailed information, how it became so successful autonomous region, and I wanted to learn more about that.
Çünkü aldığı bizden takdirimiz var.
So because we have also, as I told you, is autonomous region.
Madam Kabir, you have been a very successful businesswoman and you were a member of the People's Parliament in China. From your experience, you have known the system from within. From your experience, what would be the most effective measures that we in the West can take to help your cause at a political level or economic level or as NGOs or as civil society?
Garip dünyası Xitay'a devamlı halda, Xitay bilen sohbet ötkezge vaxtada iqtisatın birinci orğun koyup alıvatıdı hazır. Kişilik hukukunu birinci orğun koyup, her kandak xalq özünün hükümetdige muşu bizge okşaş ezilgen milletlerinin kişilik hukuk meselesini şu yerlik hükümetle devamlı sohbet ötkezgende aldın orğun koyuş gerek.
So, I would like that Western countries and the authorities of the Western countries, when they met the Chinese authorities, they should, without any hesitation, raise the human rights issues before they discuss the economic relations with China.
And devamlık özünün kün tertibige, meselen şu hükümet özünün taşkı siyasetige, meselen meyli Tibet meselesi, meyli Uyghur meselesi, taşkı siyasetige kırgız işini halk talep kılış gerek, parlamentlerde kanun makullaş gerek.
In order, of course, to force governments to do that, the public should be, should know the situation, and the people should put pressure on their governments to help the people, the Uyghurs, and they ask their governments, to raise the human rights issues of the Uyghurs and Tibetans when their leaders met the Chinese authorities.
İş bu muğandak bulanın kişilik hukuku bilen, medeniyetini kutkuzup geliş için kanun makullap Xitay hükümetine devamlı aldığı koysa, Xitay hükümeti bu ihtiyatlı da dünya arlaşkan iş boğandı kim bunda aşkarı kırışını tok tutudu.
So if the issue raised by the Western authorities, the government authorities, when they met the Chinese leaders, then China will take care, will be very careful in dealing with the Uyghurs, and because they will know that the public, the international community is aware of the situation, and the people know what's happening there.
Özanların hükümetlik işlerdek okuyucular imza toplap, biz doğruluk kanun tüzep Kıtay hükümetliğine bizni bastırışını toktutuş, doğruluk talep kılışını hükümetke ve parlamentka insanla bula icra kılıdı.
The grassroots movements will be very effective if the university students even they organize themselves and ask your governments to raise the issue of the Uyghurs and adopt some resolution in parliament and in regarding the Uyghurs, it'd be very effective. The Chinese government will be very careful then in dealing with the Uyghurs.
Siz yuqorida aytdingiz, Xitoyning siyosatini bilsizda. Xitoy hukumatı xalqaro haqiqiy orlashadigan bo'lsa, bizni bundoq yo'qotib yetmaydi, bastirib yetmaydi.
If the international community take seriously the issue of the Uyghurs, China will not dare to continue its brutal crackdown in our country.
Көзүнө жумуп турбаса, халыган чыксам дүйнө ишими демейди экен деп, муну көрдүңөр ишке айышты. 28 адамды дүйнөгө илан кылып атты, Камбоджада 20 адамымызды аткетти. Яна 3 күндүн алдыда 18 адамымызды аткетти. Сыртка кечип чыккан эч кандай гуна жок, бичара соодагерлерин тутуп акетип атты.
Because of the ignorance of the international community on the July 5th incident, because they were silenced, the Chinese authorities felt free to do whatever they wanted, and they arrested whatever people they wanted. And during last month, they sentenced 28 people to death, and also very aggressively pursue a policy in influencing, put pressure on the neighboring countries and forced the Cambodian government to return 20 Uyghurs who were involved in July 5th incident back to China. And also recently we heard that the Chinese authorities forced the Burma government to return 18 Uyghurs back to China, Uyghur refugees back to China.
Question, if I may. My question is about the relationship between human rights and fundamental freedoms and the legitimate aim of prevention of terrorism and security and the unity of a country. So this problem of finding a balance between these two issues, human rights and also security concerns, Are common also in other regions of the world. Just to mention a few, the problem of the Kurds in Turkey, or the Chechens in Russia, or in Spain with the Basque countries in Northern Ireland, and so on. So how to find, and there is always this debate about how to find a balance between security concern, prevention of terrorism, and human rights and fundamental freedom. Where is the sort of equilibrium, or what is the receipt, let's say, to find this balance?
Алды билан шу дәүләт характерлык терроризмның үзенең өлчемен бекитиш керек. Мәсәлән, диктатур дәүләтләр кандай терроризм әйтеп торады? Изилгән милләтләргә, үзенең халкыга кандай терроризм әйтеп торады? Ашының гыбы бер өлчәм бериш керек.
So of course the international community, the world should find a balance between the uh, respecting the human rights, preventing the terrorism, insecurity. But in Chinese case, there is no balance, of course. They are using, you know, terrorism as a pretext to suppress dissent and to suppress the Uyghur movement.
Kural kütüğenle adam terörizm dep karalmay. Zade kural kütürüşki kim mecbur kıldı? Endi devlet derecelik kandak, Kıtaylam emez, devlet derecelik terörizm yapırvat kalla kandak. İzilgen milletler nimi sebeptin kütüğe de bu nersini tep çıkış gerek.
And also there is no you know, armed movement even. There is no armed movement in Uyghur region. There are always, you know, peaceful demonstrations. They didn't took any arm in their hands. And also, still the China is continuing to crack down. And some people also, in the some points, there are armed struggles. And there is also a state terrorism in China. So people should pay attention to that.
Terörizm ölçümünü, terörizm degen ölçemini, mesela devlet derecelik ölçem, şu ölçemini koşuyor.
Any other question? I have then another question about the, you said that in an interview that you hope for the Uyghurs' human rights and fundamental freedoms, not only for the Uyghurs, but also for the Chinese people. So my question, which is connected also with the Google case, the fact that some unknown hackers have violated the emails of some Chinese human rights activists, and probably the Chinese authorities are behind, and now there is the sort of so-called Google case, so that even Hillary Clinton has intervened in this case. So my question is whether you can, whether there are any links, or you foreseen a link between your movement and the other Chinese human rights movements, whether this can be useful, a sort of useful network to aiming to the for the human rights in China in general.
Elbette bizim münasebetimiz var. Meyli Mongolların, Tibetlerinin ve kişilik hukuk teşkilatlarının halkarak ondan başka Hıtaylı'nın demokratiye, meyli Tiananmen'in teşkilatları, meyli Falun Gong, meyli demokratiye bulanın hepsi bilen bizim ortaklığımız var dedi.
So we have, of course, we have very close connection, a close contact with the Tibetan movements, Mongolian movement, and as well as the Chinese human rights movements. So they are very useful for our cause as well.
Münasebetimiz var. Biz ula hem de Xitaylarınki demokratiya kişilik hukuk teşkilatları Uyghurlarının hakiki ahvalını Xitay bizni, Xitay halkıga teröriz, bölgünçü deyip aşk Xitay halkı bile oturumuzu izlediye selip ulanın kolu bile öldürüp atıdı hazır. Özüdün başka. Lekin Muşla bizden hakiki ahvalımızdan düşendirdiler.
So Chinese authorities have been, you know, accusing the Uyghurs as terrorists, introducing the Uyghurs as terrorists, as separatists to the Chinese people. And this created a hatred between the Han Chinese and Uyghurs. And of course, China also using this, you know, to suppress the Uyghurs. Of course, the Chinese human rights organizations, Chinese democratic organization, is very useful in introducing the Uyghurs, the real situation of the Uyghurs, to the Chinese people and getting their support as well to the cause.
I have to ask you another question about the East Turkestan Islamic movement, the group that has been classed by the United Nations and USA as a terroristic organization, and you always deny always any links. How do you see this movement, and how what do you think about also the situation of the Guantanamo prisoners who have been accused and then released, actually, some, many of them were actually detained without justification, and some of them went to, were moved to Palau or to Albania. What is your thoughts about this, this movement?
Bizning adamlarimiz alqa bir qechib chiqsa o'zimizning qarindoshlari Qozog'iston, Qirg'iziston, O'zbekistonga qechib chiqdi. Faqat chegara pasportlarimiz yomon qattiq kontrol qilingan ekan.
Of course, many Uyghurs fled China to the neighboring countries like Kazakhstan and Kyrgyzstan because of Chinese persecution.
Xitoylarning o'ziningki 2003 yili 3 ayning 5-chi kuni e'lon qilgan gazetada Shijerboda'ganda 10 ming adam namoyish qilsa 60 ming adamning qo'liga ilinganligini e'lon qilgan Uyg'urlarning.
So in Chinese newspaper Shijerbao, I think Ms. Kadeer says, in 2003 published an article, and they said in the article it was mentioned that 10,000 people demonstrated, but 60,000 people were arrested by the Chinese authorities.
Demak, Uyghurlar aslında jenini qutuldurish uchun qochdi qashqa vaqtida Qozog'iston, Qirg'izistonda. Ma tarafimizda chegara Pakistan, Afg'oniston tog'dan atlabla tushib ketalaydi. Tibet, Hindistonga tushib ketalaydi, biz u tarafga tushib ketalaymiz. Bular jenini ep qashqandikin, qo'lda pasport bo'lmagandikin, anglishchi bilmagandikin, ularning orasiga kirib qolmaydi deyamaymiz deydi.
So many people after every Chinese crackdown, when China launched a strike hard policy, many people had to flee, many Uyghurs had to flee to flee China in order to save their lives. So they, as I told you, they will flee to Kazakhstan, Kyrgyzstan, and they will flee to Afghanistan and Pakistan, which is neighboring countries. And some of them may be, you know, involved in these, you know, movements.
Çünkü o çegra tağdan atlap da çıkalay.
So it is very easy to flee from East Turkestan to Afghanistan, because if you cross the mountains, then you are in Afghanistan.
O özünü cenni kurtuldurish uchun ularning kampisiga kirib qolganligi ras.
So some of them, in order to save their life in Afghanistan, for example, they involved in such activities and attended their camps, you know.
Şuna ularni tutqandan keyin Amerika bunu haqiqiy mushunda tashirib ularning bunda terrorist emas o'zini qutuldirish uchun chiqib asha kirib qolganligini aniqlab chiqdi.
So the people who were detained in Afghanistan in taken to the Guantanamo was the people, the Uyghurs were people who were on the wrong place at the wrong time, and of course the US government investigated, interrogated all of them for many years. They spent many years without any as they were innocent, they spent many years, and at the end the US government decided that they were innocent, that they didn't have anything to do with the terrorist movements.
And shuning orasidan bir necha odamlarning chiqib mushunda qilsak vatanni qutuldirdiga o'xshaymiz deb bunda qilmaydimi demaymiz, ya undu ya beshta u odam u bizga vakillik qila olmaydi.
Maybe of course there are a movement, as you said, maybe there are some people involved in that movements, but we don't have any kind of connections or links whatsoever with these kind of organizations.
Are you afraid of a new attack on you from Chinese government or agents?
So I think China will try to, attempt any attack on my life, but I'm not afraid of that.
There's another question here.
I would like to know something about the political situation in China. Is the government in China really so weak or unstable that it fears when it gives some autonomy, some real autonomy to some minorities like China, like Tibet or the Uyghur minority, that it could have effects on the political stability in China itself?
Şu kokkallık için bastırıp atıp da üzdün üzü guman kılıp bastırıp atıp da hazır bikadı bika günahsız adamlarını. Şu her vakit kokup durdu. Bu lağa şöyle okşuma kaşka bizden milli kimlikimiz.
So of course the Chinese leaders are afraid of, you know, afraid of situation here. If the situation get worse in these regions, that will affect the political and destiny of the Chinese leaders.
Çünkü diktator kolonu vergendikin halkın karşı çıkıdı da onunla.
But if the Chinese authorities continue to its policies, stick to its, you know, policies which has been pursuing for many years, the situation will get worse. They have to do something to solve the problem.
Ulanın mevcutluğunu tehdit edip karaydı bizden mevcutluğumuzdan, mevcut olup duruşumuzdan, milli kimliğimizden tehdit edip karaydı.
So now Chinese authorities, but according to my opinion, Ms. Kadeer says, Chinese authorities doesn't want to solve the problem. They see the Uyghurs, the existence of the Uyghurs, as a threat to themselves.
If there is some time left, just a question regarding your family. As I know, there are some more children, some more sons of you who are actually in jail in Xinjiang, East Turkestan. What do you know about them? And what's about the rest of your family, if your children still living in Xinjiang? Your sons Alim and Ablikim as we are talking now, are in jail over there. Have you got any possibility to visit, to have contacts to them, with them?
Sizler ko'rdingizlar, shu 7-nji oyning 5-idan keyin mening ballarimni va tuqqanlarimning navrilarimni hammasini televizorga ochib bütün dünyaya sözletkizip beni tıllatkızdı.
As you may aware, the Chinese authorities after the July 5th incident, in the aftermath of July 5th incident, forced my children to show up in front of the cameras and televisions and condemn that I was the instigator of the incident.
Bir onunun bir balını televizorlara çıkıp tıllaydığını bizden aile ahlakımızda mı hiç kandak yerde yok.
Of course, yeah, it is very unusual. It is against our tradition that a child come up and condemn his mother or his father.
And 12 yaş kirgen nevremni mi tıllat kızdı?
Even one of my grandchildren who was 12 years old were brought up, you know, and came up of the and condemned me.
Yana turumdaki ablikim oğlum degen ikki balamni majburlab shuning ichidan oğlum degeni chiqib televizorda meni tilladi.
And also they also forced two of my sons who are in prison because of my activities in the West to come up to the cameras and show up in front of the cameras and condemned me and my activities. But one of them, Alim, showed up, but the other, the Ablikim, didn't.
Ablikim unumaptı belkin bastırıq taşlığan buluşu mümkün.
So according to my information, because he rejected to condemn me, he was punished severely in prison.
Likim minim kerindaşlarımdan, ballarımdan, nevrilerimdan tıllığın emmisi ulanın mecburi tehdit astıdı kılıbatkallığını ben bilime.
Of course, all my brothers, my grandchildren, my children condemned me, but I know that they were forced by the Chinese authorities to do so.
Ben de ulanın ehvalarını aşındak.
So their situation is terrible.
Öydüm koklap çıkardı.
These are the last question.
I wanted to know what are your contacts to the Dalai Lama and if his politics defending the Tibetan people is also an advantage for your people, for the Uyghurs.
Elbette deydi de. Allah'ımız var, devamlı birlikte işgilimiz. Bizim ipbağın faaliyetimiz ulağa paydası var, ulağının mı bizge paydası var.
So of course we have very close contact with His Holiness Dalai. I have very close contact with His Holiness Dalai Lama. We met several times in the past and discussed our common issues. And of course, we support each other in every occasion.
Bu 50 yıl özü çıkan 50 yıl içinde biz avazımızla anlatanmağa vaxtımızdı mı? Bizim devamlı bir yer bir yerde dert oldu.
So when we were very weak, we didn't have the chance to, you know, to introduce our cause to the international public. He was very supportive. He introduced Tibetan cause and as well as the Uyghur cause to the world. So we are grateful for his help and support.
Please, the very, very short question, because Ms. Kadeer needs also rest.
Rebiya Kadeer, you are a member of the transnational radical party of Emma Bonino and Marco Pannella. Why did you decide to join this party?
Bizni ishqandaq adam tunumganda Yevropa parlamentta radikal partiyasi tunup bizning butun mushu Yevropa parlamentdagi ishlarimizdan keng ko'lamda qo'llashga erishishga asos salgan va bizga o'xshash izilgan mayli Tibet bo'lsin, mayli biz bulayli radikal partiyasi davomliq izilgan millatlar masalasiga intoin taqdiriga orlishdi.
So I'm an honor member of the this party. So I decided to be a member because the Radical Party was the party who supported, you know, our cause and brought our cause to the, you know, European Parliament, and they let them discuss our issues in that Parliament in international forum when we was very weak and we didn't have the chance to do that by our own. And this party has been supporting also the causes of the other, you know, national minorities in like Tibetans and others.
Aşı hiç qandaq millətlərliki Birləşmiş Dövlətlər Təşkilatı arlaşmığan köngül bölməydigan unutub getgan çatığı bulmay taşlıb etgan bizge oxşaş uşaq avazını anlatamagan hər qandaq millətnin işləri arlaşıb onun təqdirini alaydı berib hal qılıb özü şundaq rolunu oynaydı.
So this party has been of course, as I told you, has been very supportive for the other national minorities. And they even, you know, try to bring the issues of the other national minorities into to the international institutions.
And şuna men o partiye kiriştim, parlament başlığının ismini hazır diye unutup kaldım. O kişiye salamımı yollayım.
So I'm very grateful for their help and also for their leadership.
Ulavilemu bizem birlikte bu şu faaliyetini kollayma.
We of course I'm very, you know, grateful for their support. Thank you.
Okay, I apologize for those who also ask for questions, but our time has really come to an end. I would like just to conclude with the words of one of my co-regional, Antonio Gramsci, who happened to be the founder of the Italian Communist Party and who died in jail as a political prisoner during the fascist regime, who from jail says, I'm pessimist with the intellect and I'm optimist with the will. And I think this is also what maybe we should think of the Uyghurs movement. I wish to thank Rebiya Kadeer for her precious and illuminating words on the Uyghurs situation. I would also would like to recall that this evening at the film club there is the screening of the documentary film 10 Conditions of Love, followed by a discussion with Mrs. Kadeer. And I hope that at EURAC and here in this region that is so famous for the history of minorities accommodation, Rebiya Kadeer can find somehow a second home.